G'day and welcome back to Buildsum, and this is the fourth video in this series on building a deck. And so far we've now got the bearers in and we've worked out our spacing for our piers in this direction. So now we're going to work out the spacing for our piers in this direction, and I mean I always try and keep it the same. So we had a 1500 spacing this way, so I'm going to try and maintain a 1500 spacing this way. So again, we have to go back to our span tables. And here's the table we were using for our bearers. I keep going down. There's actually two different tables for our joists. They've done it two different ways. One is using a common span. So we can come down here and we can just go, okay, I want 1500. I want MGB 10 because that's what my bearers are made out of. So for 1500 MGP 10, I can use 90 by 45 as my joist, and that'll get me my 1500 span. Okay, and you can do that. Sorry, that's for a single span at 450 mil spacing. If I wanted a continuous span, 1500, still 90 by 45. So I'm pretty happy with using 90 by 45 for my joists. The other table is a little bit different. If we actually go up here, we can see if I wanted to go 90 by 45 in my MGP 10, where is it? 90 by 45. So it's MGP 10, it's saying a span of 1400. So it must be a little bit, that's for a single span. And for a continuous span, 90 by 45, I can get 1700 out of it. So if you wanted to, with 90 by 45, you could go up to a span of 1700. All right, but as I said, I want to keep my piers pretty much the same. So I'm going to run with a 1.5 meter span. And you can lessen that to suit the width of your deck. It doesn't really matter. You pick the timber that you think is the most economical for your actual situation. Okay, the other thing to remember is when we're framing up, we have to make sure that we keep the bearers away from the building. And it's not so bad in this case because I've actually put in a row of piers off the building and we're going to cantilever up to the wall. All right, but if you were to put in what they call engaged piers, all right, you would have to make sure that you had at least 25 mil in here so that the termites can't cross that gap without being seen and get into the building. All right. And the other problem with doing engaged piers is you have to dig down to your original footing. Hopefully there's enough footing left to put the pier on. Otherwise you'd have to be bulking up the footing as well. So it's not a very common method. More common to use the, just build the piers off the wall, put them on their own footing. Okay, and then that way your bearer is going to be a long way off the wall. When we put our joists in, as you can see here on this end, we had about a 400 mil or 500 mil cantilever allowable. This would only be a couple of hundred mil, maybe 300. So that's quite allowable, and we make sure that they finish 25 mil from the wall. It's not going to make any difference with our deck. It's not going to look bad, because our actual decking boards can finish a little bit closer, but it just gives us that separation for termites. Okay. Well, let me get back to there. Let that fix itself up. Yeah, and that's a 25 mil. Okay, so in the next video, we'll look at the next step and getting our decking boards down and completing the deck.
G'day, I'm back. Just to let you know that if you like this video, you can subscribe to my YouTube channel or you can follow me on Facebook so you don't miss out on more great videos.